Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to start with a new chapter, the chapter titled Image Restoration. For digital image processing, we started with first of all the introduction and the fundamentals of digital image and its processing. Now we are introduced with all the image transform that are very potential tool and the fundamental steps that are required for digital image processing. We started chapter wise. So we are covered with image enhancement, particularly into the spatial domain and in frequency domain. Now the next fundamental step for digital image processing is image restoration. So let us begin with the first topic of it, a model of image restoration or image degradation we can call. So here we can start with our topic, a model of image restoration or degradation we can say, very essential to understand digital image processing. Now to begin with the actual model, we will take the preview first of all. So to talk about the background and the digital image processing, we must have a specific goal to consider any of the image processing task here. So what is the goal of image restoration is a question. So a goal we can say to have the improvement of the image in some predefined sense. So to look at this particular goal, there may be a question in your mind, then what is the difference with the image enhancement? Because the image enhancement that we covered into previous two chapters had the same goal. For image enhancement, we said that to have the better quality of visualization of image with respect to the human vision perception, we carried image enhancement in either the spatial domain and in frequency domain. Now, what is the difference with the image restoration if it has the same kind of goal? So, we can say that image enhancement was actually a subjective process that has taken the advantage of the psychological aspects of the human visual system. While covering the image enhancement, I have already stated that image enhancement as a subjective method, the ultimate judge to compare which particular method of image enhancement is better is our visualization. So it depends on to the user only. There is no objective parameters to compare and evaluate the results of the image enhancement. So to have the image enhancement, the image restoration differs in this way. Image restoration is an objective process assuming a priori knowledge of the degradation process. Now, the inverse of this process is applied in order to recover the original image. So, the features of the image restoration can be listed as, here we have the objectiveness of the evaluation for the purpose of image restoration, whereas the image enhancement is completely a subjective process. For image restoration, we require to have a prior knowledge, whereas the image enhancement we can say is a heuristic process. A prior knowledge of the degradation phenomenon we shall consider in this starting for the image restoration, along with the modeling the degradation and applying the inverse process to recover the original image. Now, what is the target of image restoration? The target while having the image restoration process will be the first one to have a degraded digital image. So we want the original image without any kind of information loss, a two-dimensional signal we always say. So we want some kind of degradation to it, then we can carry out the restoration process. So in this particular process of having the degradation, the sensor, digitizer, display degradations are less considered. The spatial domain approach is also there for image restoration. As well, we have the frequency domain approach. Now, the degradation of the image, how it look like, we can show you with this particular diagram. So we shall be having a show of degradation image and then the image restored while having the task, the process, the techniques that we are going to learn in this particular chapter applied to this degraded image. So let us have the visualization of degraded image first of all. So this is the degraded image because of the blur due to motion type. Now, after application of the image restoration techniques to this particular image, after processing we output this particular image, we can say this is the restored image. So this image we have shown for the grayscale images. Another example we can take for the grayscale image, where the degraded image will be having like this. So you can say that the original image that should be there, the scenario should be without any kind of noise. So for every pixel you find the noise here of periodic type, that the details we are going to see in one of the next topic. So this is actually the degraded image and we want to recover the original details. So after having the image restoration, we may get such type of restored image. See, the comparison gives you a clear understanding what is the goal of image restoration here: to recover all the original details moving out of the degraded image here. So now we have the example of the color image for image restoration also. The degraded image, if for example is this much, we can see a bird having a flower with it. So here we have some kind of noise into the surroundings as well as the bird itself. So after image restoration applied, we can obtain a very clear image. So I hope the image restoration goal, the target, is very much clear to you people. Now the outline that we are going to follow in this particular chapter, having the image restoration, we can start with a model of image restoration or image degradation, we can say. Then it will be following the various noise models that we are going to introduce. So these are actually the Gaussian noise, the Rayleigh noise, the Erlang, also called as gamma noise, exponential noise, uniform noise, and salt and pepper noise. So these six noise models we are going to introduce, with which the original image can be degraded here. Next, we shall see what are the parameters possible to have the objective evaluation, the objectiveness of image restoration. Next, we can have the restoration in the presence of noise. So it shall cover the mean filter, order statistic filter, adaptive filters. Next, we can have the periodic noise reduction by frequency domain filtering. It will take the band reject filters, band pass filters, notch filters for the purpose of image restoration that we will see. We will have the introduction to linear position invariant degradations, followed by estimating the degradation function exactly, the inverse filtering, which is very much popular for image restoration purpose, followed by another very popular and the potential tool for image restoration, that is a minimum mean square error, also called as Wiener type of filtering. We have the introduction to maximum likelihood method for the purpose of image restoration, constrained least square filtering, and geometric mean filter, and lastly the image reconstruction from the projections. So this shall be the complete outline that we are going to follow in this particular chapter. Now let us get back to our first topic, which is a model of image restoration process. So a image restoration process, we can show you with the help of a block diagram, a model, you can simply say. So the degradation process here shall be modeled as a degradation function. Here we shall represent it with the help of capital H, and for the purpose of degradation, the additive noise will be there to the original image, that we can represent eta as a function of x comma y. Basically x and y are the spatial coordinates. So simply, if eta as a function of x comma y will be there, we can say that it is of spatial nature. Next, given some knowledge of h, that is degradation function, and the noise eta as a function of x and y, the objective of the image restoration is to obtain the estimate of the original image. So this is the block diagram, a model of image restoration process. So we can start from the left hand side. Here we have f of xy, the original image. So f of xy shall be operated by the degradation function capital H, represented here. After the original image is degraded, so here at this point we expect the degraded image, and it shall be added by the noise, represented here eta as a function of x comma y. So after image degradation and addition of noise, whatever the image we obtained, that is having a lot of losses of information, we can represent G of XY. Then actually the task, the methods we are going to learn in this chapter, that are restoration filter methods, simply image restoration methods, can be applied to such a degraded and noise affected image to obtain the restored image that we can represent F cap as a function of X comma Y here. So in this certain model of image restoration process, from the original image that is having the representation on left hand side F of XY up to this particular point, we can say it is simply a degradation process. And afterwards, the exactly the fundamental step into the digital image processing, that is image restoration, will start. So in this particular model of image restoration process, the mathematical formulation we can represent to obtain G of X comma Y, the degraded image, computed as F of XY, the original image, having a spatial convolution with that of the H of XY, a degradation function, and this convolved output shall be added with eta as a function of X comma Y, representing the noise here. So the first equation is actually the representation of the image restoration process into the spatial domain, whereas in the frequency domain, in the Fourier domain, simply we can say the degraded image can be represented as G of U comma V, so which shall be simply the multiplication of the Fourier of F of XY original image with that of the Fourier of the H of UV, the degradation function. As we know that the convolution into the spatial domain is simply multiplication into the frequency domain. Hence, instead of having a convolution sign here, we simply have the product of the two terms here. Next, it shall be added with the Fourier of the frequency domain representation of the noise that we are going to add to it. So this mathematical formulation is simply the frequency domain representation of image restoration process. Now the degradation function, the first block into the model that we have seen onto the previous slide, that we have represented by capital H. So there are certain typical assumptions about this degradation function H that we are going to see. The first assumption is that H is a linear function. Degradation function is a linear function. Here we can represent H of F1 added with H of F2 to give H of F1 plus F2. So if F1 and F2 are the two separate informations, we can say the image informations, and we operate the H degradation function onto these information separately and add the results. So it is nothing but first of all addition of these informations and operating it with the help of simply the degradation function. So this is a simple expression to represent the linearity of the degradation function that we are going to denote with the help of capital H. Further, here we can have also H of F multiplied with that of the K, a linear operator, a linear constant we can say. So it is simply nothing but H operated onto the K multiplied with the information, that is small f here. Next, H assumption is again to be the shift invariant. So for that purpose, we have if H operated onto the image sample generally represented as F of XY shall give us G of XY, the degraded image, then H operated onto the F of X minus A, Y minus B, where for the spatial coordinates X and Y, we are showing you the shift into the location. So the resultant shall be G of X minus A, Y minus B. So whatever the shift we have into the input signal, the same shift we obtain into the output. Hence we can call H function is shift invariant. It is not going to alter any kind into the localization of the spatial parameters here. Hence the meaning we can give, that is shifting the input merely shifts the output by the same amount. Next, the degradation model, what we have seen, we shall see with respect to assuming the linearity and shift invariance of the degradation function. So let us write first of all F of XY, the original image that we have represented onto the left hand side of the model into the block diagram form we have shown. So the writing shall be f of xy, that is computed by having the double integral, the integration from minus infinity to plus infinity. So as we have the integral signs shown here, it means the original information is represented into this original image with lot of details here. So this shall be operated onto f of ab along with the impulse function represented by del as a function of x minus a, y minus b into the differential a, differential b here. Then h operated onto such the information original in form, that is f of xy, can be expressed as, here we have h operated onto f of xy. So simply we apply h for the complete RHS that we have shown, the double integral ranging from minus infinity to plus infinity operated onto the product of f of ab with the impulse del as a function of x minus a, y minus b with the differentials of a and b here. So further we obtain it. So we have the integrals, first of all h we apply inside the bracket for the product of f of ab and the del of x minus a, y minus b. So now we can have the integrals f of a comma b, and it shall be h operating onto the del of x minus a, y minus b with the differentials. So here we can see that the degradation model we are going to see with respect to assuming the linearity and shift invariance. So this h operator is getting operated onto the impulse only. Now since h of xy is shift invariant, we can operate h onto the del as a function of x comma y. Simply we can write here h of xy. So this shall imply that the capital H over the del onto x minus a, y minus b shall be simply h in bracket x minus a, y minus b here. Therefore we can say that capital H operated onto the f of xy shall be the double integral minus infinity to plus infinity f of ab in product with h of x minus a, y minus b with the differentials a and b shall be simply the convolution of f of xy with that of the h of xy, that is representation into the spatial domain. Hence simply we can write g of xy, that is the representation for the degradation image, can be obtained by h operated onto f of xy plus addition of noise, either you represent with n or eta as a function of xy here. So this is the same representation of the convolution. In place of the first term h operated onto the f of xy, we have the representation convolution of the original image f of xy with that of the degradation function in spatial domain h of xy here. Now with the knowledge of model of image restoration process, we are going to introduce to people the four types of image blur with which we can degrade the original image. So let us get the information about what exactly the blur is. Blur can be introduced by improperly focused lens, relative motion between the camera and the scene, or atmospheric turbulence. So blurring is a form of bandwidth reduction of the ideal image owing to the imperfect image formation process. It can be caused by relative motion between the camera and the scene, or by the optical system that is out of focus. Image blurs can be broadly classified as, we have the gauss blur, the out of focus blur, and the motion blur, and finally we shall see the atmospheric turbulence blur also. So let us begin with the first type of image blur, that is gauss blur. The gauss blur is defined by the following point spread function. So we give the formula for, so h of xy shall represent that particular gauss blur given by 1 divided by sigma in multiplication with the square root of 2 pi, and this particular ratio is having a multiplication with the exponent, that is e to the power minus times x square plus y square divided by twice sigma square. So in this formulation representing the Gaussian, the sigma square generally represents the variance here. So sigma simply the variance of the blur. The gauss blur occurs mainly due to the long time atmospheric exposure. So now the second type is out of focus blur. So this blurring is produced by a defocused optical system. the distribution of a single point uniformly over a disk surrounding the point is the one here. The point spread function of the out of focus blur is given by the expression that we shall see here. So again, the representation of h of xy on the RHS, we have c multiplied by the two values here with the specific conditions. The first value shall be 1 multiplied to the c. If under root of, here we have the addition of the two terms, that is x minus cx bracket square with that of y minus cy bracket square, the complete one less than or equal to r here. Otherwise, the second value is 0 for this condition not true. So where r is actually the radius and c suffix x and c suffix y is the center of the out of focus point spread function. The scaling factor c, that is having a multiplication with either 1 or 0, has to be chosen such that it satisfies the condition of having double integral of h of xy over dx and dy shall be equal to 1 here. Now the next type, the third type, that is very popular one, that is motion blur. Based on to the motion blur into the image, we are going to have a simple MATLAB demonstration also to show you how the image can be affected by motion blur in the next topic as well. So regarding motion blur, it is actually due to the relative motion between the recording device and the scenario. When an object or the camera is moved during light exposure, a motion blurred image is produced. The motion blur can be in the form of translation, a rotation, a sudden change of scale, or some combinations of these reasons here. Regarding motion blur, we can say that when the scene to be recorded translates relative to camera at a constant velocity, the velocity represented as v suffix relative under the angle of phi radians with the horizontal axis during exposure interval 0 to t exposure in suffix, the distortion is one dimensional. Here we can represent capital L given by v relative by t exposure we can have. The point spread function is then further given by h of x, y, l and phi as the function. The first option that is opted for this motion type of blur representation is 1 upon capital L, the capital L computed by this particular formula v relative and t exposure. If square root of x square plus y square is less than or equal to L by 2 and x by y is actually minus of tangential of the angle phi here. Otherwise, the value should be 0 for the motion blur function. The discrete version of the equation that just now we have shown you is not easily captured in a closed form expression in general. For a specific case, when phi angle is equal to 0, an appropriate approximation is given by, so here we can represent h as a function of n1, n2 and capital L. So it is having the three values here. So first value is 1 upon capital L. If the condition is n1 is equal to 0 and the magnitude of n2 shall be less than or equal to the mod of, here we have L minus 1 divided by 2. The second option, we have the value for this particular representation of function shall be given by 1 upon twice L in multiplication with, here we have L minus 1 minus twice of mod of L minus 1 divided by 2. If the condition n1 is equal to 0, the mod of n2 equal to the mod of L minus 1 divided by 2. If these conditions are not true, that time we shall assign 0 to this representation. Next and the last type of the image blur, we have atmospheric turbulence blur. So it is a severe limitation in the case of remote sensing images. Although this blur depends on a variety of factors, the factors we can give, like the blur depends on what exactly the temperature variation is there, the wind speed at the time of capturing the scenario, the exposure time for long time exposures, the point spread function can be described reasonably well by the Gaussian function. So the representation is h as a function of x, y, and here the Gaussian variance we can represent, that is sigma suffix g, so shall be given by c in multiplication with the exponential of minus x square plus y square divided by twice sigma g square here. So here sigma g determines the amount of spread of the blur and the constant c is to be chosen so that the above equation is satisfied. So with this particular information, we are covered with the first topic, a model of image restoration process, image degradation process, we can say. By the next lecture, we shall start with a simple MATLAB demonstration to show you how exactly the original image can be affected with a motion type of blur. So I hope the information definitely benefits you for the knowledge of digital image processing. If you like the videos and want some more information, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.